professor of cardiology and past head of cardiology department at Alexandria University, and also the co-chairperson of Alex Cardio Alex. Hello, doctor.
Hello.
How are you? Can we talk about what's new in Cardio Alex this year?
Cardio Alex 2018 is one of the most biggest cardiology conference in the Middle East. For this conference, the all cardiologists all over the Egypt attend the conference, the Arab cardiologists, and even the Africa, the European, and the American professors of cardiology attend this conference. The number of attendees is increasing this year. The number over 7,000 registered in this conference, and we hope the number may be greater than this. We always interesting of the young generators of the doctors, the young doctors. A large number of young doctors attend this conference as chairpersons in the sessions, speakers, to give a chance to the young doctors. We chair the clinical pharmacy. The clinical pharmacy is an important part cooperation with the cardiologists, increasing the number of hours for the clinical pharmacy, about 3 hours, 1.5 hour lectures, and 1.5 hours workshop. Also, the continuous medical education. As I mentioned, we are interested in the young doctors, the continuous medical education for what is updates in all branches of cardiology. We always, every one day, there is a new in the cardiology, the updates in the cardiology. And in every specialty, we have what is called updates and what is new in the intervention, in the dyslipidemia, in hypertension, in all branches of cardiology. Also, we are interesting for the nurses. We add lectures for the nurses and technicians, because the medical team, we work as a medical team.
Doctor, what's new in the treatment of the acute coronary syndrome and diagnosis?
Acute coronary syndrome, as we know, is STEMI or non-STEMI. You can differentiate into two types of acute myocardial infarction, STEMI and non-STEMI. The new, as regards the guidelines, there is a concept in the cardiology called time is a muscle. So early intervention is important. In patients presenting with STEMI, primary DCI is the best choice for the treatment, and we give information to the doctors that patients come to the emergency room with STEMI must be primary BCI the line of therapy of choice, and this primary BCI may be in the hospital capable of primary BCI, you can do it, or transfer patient to a hospital capable of primary BCI. There is a new in the guidelines as regards the drug therapy, how to interfere with the patients as regards the anticoagulation, the antiplatelet therapy, post BCI. There is a new about the updates of the stents. The stents, we have a new generations, up to fourth generation of the drug-eluting stent, and we have to risk stratify our patients, the bleeding risk and ischemic risk, and how to risk stratify our patients and put the correct and the best line of therapy for each individual patient.
Okay, what do we expect next year in CardioAlex?
We expect in next year that the number will be more attendees, a chair of our colleagues will be more, the foreign guests from all over the world will be more. This year, more than 80 foreign guests attend this conference. We hope that the number is increasing. And as I mentioned, every day there is an update in cardiology, but we hope that will be a successful conference.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Doctor. Thank you.